As I walk in, the processes that I go through, the first things that I'm going to start to think about: how long is the room, how wide is the room, how high are the ceilings, what are the nature of the materials that I'm seeing within the room. As I look at this room here, I'm going to walk over towards the walls and just take a look at it, you know, knocking on it. I immediately know this is a sheetrock wall construction. If we had a concrete wall construction, it would be harder, would bring more of the low frequency back. Also, not sure if you can see in the cameras, can we see the absorptive panels up on the wall? Let's see if we can just pan up there for a moment. This particular room, obviously people have thought about some of the speech intelligibility issues. They've come on in and they've put what looks to be a 2-inch compressed fiberglass panels up on the wall. The key here, trying to get these early reflections down, that slope of the first 100 milliseconds of decay, these areas that have tremendous impact on that echo coming back. So here's a room where they've done some good work. They've come in, they've put panels up here on the wall. On the far side of the wall, we have a projector here. We've got a screen. We've got a bunch of glass windows, which are outside of the camera view right now. But there's a bunch of glass. So once again, the glass is going to bring some energy back. The floor is some type of a linoleum tile that's relatively hard. Generally, as I come into a room, even before I start the testing, I'm going to come in, I'm just going to clap my hands a couple of times and start to see, you know, what do I hear? You know, do I hear a lot of slapback echo coming in? Do I hear a lot of reverberation? Matt, could you just clap a couple of times? And so this is sounding pretty good in here. The high frequency, a lot of it's being taken up by the absorptive panels. I don't hear a long tail on it, like in a big room, the gymnasium will work, and afterwards where you'll clap your hands and for a second or more, you'll continue to hear the sound decaying down. So I know that the reverberation times are relatively short in this room. That's, you know, biding well for it. The next question I'm going to have is where should the loudspeakers be installed within the room? And that's going to vary depending upon the state that you're in. You're going to have to look at your national fire code as adopted in your individual state. At the moment, we're in Connecticut. So let's take a look at what was done here. And as I come up on the wall here, I see a fairly standard wheel lock box. It has a strobe built into it. It has a loudspeaker into the back of it. There are 1, 2, 3 other doors that go out of this room. And out of those, we have this one, which is at the end of the room. And then at the center of the room, there's another exit, which has the same wheel lock box on it. So what have we got here? We've got 2 small loudspeakers, which are brought over towards the exit doors. The upside of that is that in an emergency, most people will move towards an exit. And as a result, as they get towards an area you would expect them to go, the intelligence is going to improve. Typically, you get closer to the loudspeaker, you're going to come within the area we call critical distance, where the sound is still decaying at that inverse square law. So that's sensible. In other jurisdictions, typically the loudspeakers would go above in order to give us a grid pattern looking down for coverage of the space. We're going to test this room, so we will see how this will actually work, what kind of levels we can achieve with these particular loudspeakers, and what type of coverage we get for intelligibility. Given the acoustical panels, we have a dimension here on this room of about, I'm looking at the floor panels here, and the floor panels are about 3 foot, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 24. We've got about 30 foot of room, so probably, you know, 20 something by about 30 something. Seems sensible. First impressions on this room look pretty good. As I'm speaking into the mic, and this is another thing that I'll always do, is I'll just have people stand across the room from me. and just my natural voice speaking, I'll see whether or not they're understanding me. I can hear some reflection coming back, so there's, you know, some issue here. And also remember that in a room full of people, as we add noise, that's going to decrease intelligibility, because that's going to reduce signal to noise. Another one of the factors that we're going to go through here in the calculation of intelligibility as done in STIPAW.